The folks over at the Nashville Songwriters Association International have a slogan. It all begins with a song.
It does.
And that was a dynamite song.
Thanks, Ray. I appreciate it.
Wow. And, you know, you've been very fortunate, in my opinion, to get your hands on a lot of dynamite songs. and you came across one of the best songs ever written, in my opinion, in this town. And it's called The Wind Beneath My Wings. Do you know, how did that happen?
Well, you know, I wrote for Warner Brothers Music at the time, and Larry Henley and Jeff Silbar are the two writers on the song. And they were working on it, I believe, in the next room. And if I would have just walked in for just a moment, I would have been a writer on that song, but it didn't work out that way. But so I heard it practically at conception, and I went, man, that's just song is written for me to sing. It was just a great song. It was a struggle as a record, though.
Well, you know, he's talking about Larry Henley. He was a member of the New Beats, the lead singer. They sang that song, I like bread and butter. and that's just was a hit because it was so weird, I think. But Jeff Silbar, the other writer on the song, was married to the niece of my longtime secretary, Shirley Welch. And so I've known Jeff for a long time.
Right.
And two very talented guys. We lost Larry recently.
Oh, yeah, I know.
And, but Jeff's still with us. I got to bring up the fact that the man that signs you to Warner Brothers.
Noro.
One of my oldest friends, Norris D. Wilson. Everybody calls him Noro. And how could you not sign Gary Morris?
Well, I tell you what. When I had come to town and done some demos, and it was back 2 years earlier, and Harold Bradley had produced those.
Yeah.
And so when I came to town to make records, I only knew one name. It was Harold Bradley. And I called him. I said, who should I talk to? And he said this, there is only one man in this town that makes records that will understand how you sing. And his name is Noro Wilson. And I kept trying to get an appointment, and I was living up on 18th Avenue South in a little one-bedroom shotgun apartment. One day I went up, you know, Warner Brothers used to be right across from your office on Grand,
oh, yeah.
That little house.
Absolutely.
I walked in, I sat down, and I said, I'm here to see Noro. And they said, do you have an appointment? I went, no. And he said, well, he's busy. And I said, I'll wait. And that was about 10 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I got to see him. He took me into his office. He called L.A., and he played a cassette of mine, and I effectively was signed right then. So it was. But he understood me
I
as a
singer.
I bet
he felt bad about making you wait so long.
I hope
he did.
He didn't. He
I'm going to give him a rough time about
all
that.
Right.
Well, we've waited long enough, ladies and gentlemen. Why don't you do that career-making song for us?
I'd love to.
Gary Morris.
Must have been cold there in my shadow. Never have sunlight on your face. You've been content to let me shine. You always walked a step behind. I was the one with all the glory. Well, you were the one with all the strength. Only a face without a name. I never once heard you complain. Did you ever
might like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. It might have appeared to go unnoticed, but I've got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything I'd like to be.
That was wonderful. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming and being with us on CabaRay Nashville.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't need to say it, but I will. Gary Morris.
Thank you.
Wow. One of the best singers.